I'm Elisa with Scripts and Scribes. We're at the Writers Guild Foundation TV Writers Symposium, and we have the honor of speaking with Christos and Ruth Gage. Thank you so much for talking with us. So I guess where I'd like to start, before we get into Daredevil, because I know that that's what everyone's probably really wanting to know about, our site is for aspiring writers of all genres, and so I'd like to kind of address that, and if you could both give me a little bit of a breakdown of how you got into the industry and how you got your break, and I know you do comic writing and other forms, so if you could just kind of give us a little taste of what it was like when you were coming up.
Well, we actually met at AFI Film School, and so we went there and kind of started working out of there. Ruth actually had some experience working for people in when she worked for the state of North Carolina. She worked with Michael Mann. I'll let her tell that, but it's not that exciting. Went to film school.
Well, I actually didn't have sort of the access that Chris had when I was growing up. So I knew from the time I was a little kid that I wanted to tell stories, but I didn't really understand the process of telling stories, and especially film and television. So mine's a little, my path is a little, it's not quite as straight as Chris's was. He sort of always knew he wanted to be a screenwriter. So basically, when I was in undergraduate school, what I had access to that was really good was theater. And so we had a Lort Theater, a very small Lort Theater. So I started working actually as a director with the directors at that Lort Theater, and then realized that some of their associates were doing plays at the Goodman Theater in Chicago. And so I got a grant from my university, and this had never been done before, and I flew to Chicago and sort of informed the theater company that I was going to come to Chicago.
And I was paving your own way.
I was going to assist August Wilson and Lloyd Richards and Frank Galati and Robert Falls and Steve Tessich, who were all, they were all people who crossed over into film and television and theater. And so once I finished that grant work study program, I came home to North Carolina, and I worked also in politics, and I was working for the state, and I got a call from the film commissioner that Michael Mann was trying to shoot Last of the Mohicans in the western part of the state, which is where I was from. But there were a lot of difficulties, and the woman in the film commission office asked me if I would go up and meet with them. And so I drove up to western North Carolina, and I sat down with them and went over everything that they were trying to do for about a week. And I took their contracts, and I changed a bunch of stuff around, and they offered me a job. So that was in a much more producerial capacity, but I got to sit and watch Michael Mann shoot Last of the Mohicans for a year. So I was with him on almost every set, and so he and John Landau, who's James Cameron's producing partner, then helped me get into AFI and USC and NYU, and I went to AFI. I chose AFI, and that's where Christos and I met. I was really, really lucky at AFI because at the time they had your second year could be a dual program, which is called the residence program, in which you could develop a screenplay. So most programs today do not allow directors and producers to develop a screenplay, but I was the only person in my class that chose to develop a screenplay with the writer. And so we developed a screenplay that ended up getting us a manager and, you know, that sort of stuff.
A woman of many talents, apparently. I can see why you chose her. I mean, I don't know about him. You seem pretty straightforward. So, no. I think that it's nice that we kind of have the duality there. You know, yours was a little bit more of a scattered route almost.
Right.
You know, it wasn't a straight shot, and yours was a little bit more of a straight shot. And I think it shows that there's so many different ways that you can really get there.
Yeah.
It's not one path. But the commonality here is that, you know, something that a lot of writers say is, you know, having a strong network can be really helpful for you when you're coming up and building around you. And I think maybe school is a great place for that.